prestigious knowledge and learning channel. In this video, we will see about difference between analog and digital filters. So the difference between analog and digital filter, first you draw a tabular column. First column analog filter and second column is digital filter. It operates on analog signal. In analog signal, the first point is it operates on analog signals. In digital filter, it operates on digital samples of the signal. Second point, it is represented by differential equation. For example, d square y of t by dt square plus dy of t by dt plus y of t is equal to dx of t by dt plus phi x of t. Here in digital filter, it is represented by differential equation. Example, y of n minus 2 plus phi y of n minus 1 plus 6 y of n is equal to x of n. So how to convert this differential equation to a transfer function? Okay, let us take Laplace transform. Since this is a differential equation, we have to take Laplace transform on both sides. So d square y of t by dt square will become s y of s, and dy of t by dt will become s y of s, y of t will become y of s, dx of t by dt will become s x of s, and phi x of t will become phi x of s. So combine y of s terms. Here we have s square, s, y of s coefficient here is 1. So s square plus s plus 1. And here x of s, you take s and plus phi common. So h of s is equal to y of s by x of s, which is equal to s plus phi divided by s square plus s plus 1. Where h of s is the transfer function of an analog filter. If we substitute s is equal to j omega, it will become h of j omega is equal to j omega plus phi divided by j omega the whole square plus j omega plus 1. So these are the steps for analog filter. If we take digital filter, since digital filter is represented by a differential equation, we have to take z transform on both sides. So y of n minus 2 will give you y of z power n, z power minus 2 plus 5 y z, y of z power minus 1 plus 6 y of z is equal to x of z. Combine y of z, x of z terms, you will get h of z is equal to y of z by x of z, which is equal to 1 divided by z power minus 2 plus 5 z power minus 1 plus 6. So here h of z is the transfer function of a digital filter. As we have seen, h of s is the transfer function of analog filter. Here h of z is the transfer function of the digital filter, in which frequency response can be written by substituting z is equal to e power j omega in terms of z. So h of e power j omega is equal to, in the place of z, if we substitute e power j omega, so power minus 2 and power j omega will get multiplied and will give you e power minus j 2 omega plus 5 e power j omega into minus 1 will give you e power minus j omega plus 6. So this is the second difference. And the third point is, it consists of components. Analog filter consists of components like resistors, capacitors, etc., in which the digital filter consists of logic circuits like multiplier, adder, shift registers, etc. The fourth point is, it is easily affected by environments and temperature. In digital filter, it is not affected by environment and temperature. So the fifth point is, the frequency response is modified by changing the value of components. In digital filter, frequency response can be modified by changing the value of filter coefficients. So these are the differences between analog filter and digital filter. Now we will see advantages of digital filter over analog filter. So first advantage, high level of accuracy, easily programmable, large storage capacity, insensitive to temperature variations, high thermal stability, multiple filtering is available, digital filters operate at wide range of frequencies, it is highly immune to noise. So these are the advantages of digital filters over analog filter. Even though digital filter has many advantages, it has some disadvantages too. Let me explain disadvantages of digital filter. So the first point is quantization error. So quantization can be done by the process of rounding and truncation, which causes errors. So quantization error occurs due to finite word length in the representation of signals and parameters. Okay, so this is the disadvantage of digital filter. Next, what are the properties to be maintained than an analog filter should have for the effective transformation of digital filter? First, left half of the S plane should map inside the unit circle of the Z plane, and right half of the S plane should be mapped outside the unit circle of Z plane. So left half of the S plane should be mapped outside the unit circle, as we said earlier. Left half of the S plane should be mapped inside the unit circle. Left half, see, this is left half. Left half should be mapped inside the unit circle, and right half should be mapped outside the unit circle. So this is S plane and this is Z plane. Z plane will have a unit circle. This is H of S and this is H of Z. Next, we will see methods to convert analog filter to digital filter. So we have four methods: bilinear transformation technique, approximation of derivatives, impulse invariant transformation, and matched Z transform. So in this video, we saw differences between analog and digital filter. We revised 5 points and advantages of digital filter over analog filter, disadvantage of digital filter, and the properties to be maintained while transforming an analog filter to a digital filter. So the properties have been explained. S plane, left side of the poles of the S plane should be mapped inside the unit circle, and right side of the poles of the Z plane should be mapped, of the S plane should be mapped outside the unit circle. And we have studied only the name of the methods to convert analog filter to digital filter. In detail, we will see in the next video. Thank you for watching the video. For more topics, please subscribe to this channel. Comment if you want any other topics as videos. Thank you.